Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel, Beauty in Dates. If you're new, hi, I'm Divya. In today's video, I have created this cohesive makeup look, which is a pink cohesive makeup look that the eyeshadow we have pink and in the lips also we have pink and the similar tone is of the blush, and this look I believe can go with a white dress or a pink dress, and obviously it's pink and we are girls, so we can just go ahead with this look with so many of the outfits. And if you're interested to know how we created this look, then please keep on watching. For my foundation, I have taken the Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the shade 125 nude beige. If you are buying this foundation, then make sure that you find your foundation in one or two shade lighter if you don't want your foundation to turn dark after its oxidization. I'll be using it over my lid as well, and then just blend it with as much perfection as much you can. Now, since I do not suffer from very severe dark circles, I just use a double layer of this foundation on my eyelids as well. I don't overdo it because I just want my skin to show through, and I didn't want my base to look very heavy, just because I want this makeup look to be fresh and natural. And then again, blend, extending it to your neckline as well. Moving on to next step, that is setting our foundation. I have used the Rimmel Stay Matte London Compact. Rimmel London Stay Matte Compact. And I just use a buff to set this as well. I tend to get oily. Now the season right now is quite dry, so make sure that you do not use a loose powder, because loose powder just absorb a lot of oil and moisture from your face. Then I've used this Take Quirky lipstick. The color which I'll be using on my lips is similar to the color of blush, which should be similar. So I've used lipstick as my blush and just blend it on your cheekbones. I thought it was too much, so I just toned it down with my foundation brush. Contouring my face with this Sugar face palette. This one is in the shade Subtle. And then I filled my eyebrows with the dark brown eyebrow pencil, and this pencil does not have any specific brand, it was just from a local beauty store. Just filling in the sparse area in the center of my brows and in the initials of my brows. Eyes, I've used the LA color Sweet 16 eyeshadow palette, and from this I have used this very light shade as my transition shade. You very necessarily don't need this, but it looks good when you have a transition shade and the color just merge into each other really well. And also at the outer corners it looks very beautifully merged out when you use a transition shade, but you can just start it with a pink color initially as well. Just fancy things or pro things, what do you call it. Then I'll take a slightly dark orange shade here. Now I know this is a pink color tone makeup, but when you just want to transition beautiful. Next up, I have taken this slightly dark orange shade as my next transition or crease color, I would say more specifically. I'll be putting and placing this color and depositing it in my crease, just so that the next color of ours, that is pink, just mix into the previous light orange color beautifully. This is how it looks. Next up, we will jump into the pink color finally, and I'll just replacing it on the outer V. The maximum deposition of the pink color will be in the outer V, and then slightly extending it all over my lids. And finally, just blending all the three colors into each other as beautifully as you can. And then I'll be taking this slightly shimmer shade with my fingers in the inner half of the lid will be covered with a shimmer shade. I deposited several times because the pigmentation was slightly sheer and I wanted to cover all the pink underneath, thinning out all the fallouts. I've taken a mixture of these two colors and I'll be highlighting my inner corners. I'm used to of just extending my inner corner way too much, and then I just set it with or correct it with a compact buff, and whatever is left on the brush I'll be just smudging my lower lash line. This is a good trick. If you don't know how to do your lower lash line, then whatever is left on your brush, that just gives you the right amount of color to be put in the lower lash line. Next up, I have used a brown gel liner. You can either use black, but a black liner would be too harsh for pink color. Since pink is a soft color, it's better that we use soft color. So I have not actually used this as a liner, but I've just filled in my lash line just so that they look dense, and using it as close to my lash line as possible. You can see it was a very fine work to do. Take a small mirror because I could not see into the mirror in which I did my whole makeup. Leave me, I'm not this serious kind of person as I look on camera, but I just don't know what happens to me while I'm on camera, or maybe just making my voice. So I'm not this kind of pretty. I just feel pity for myself when I see myself making voiceovers. And next is my favorite part, that is mascara, and my one and only favorite mascara, which gives me the curling effect, which gives me a good volume. And yes, it's the Maybelline Hyper Curl Volume Express Mascara. I'll be using two coats of mascara. I don't wear falsies, they are like too heavy for my eyes. I don't know, I am used to of using them. I am very horrible in doing fine works, so it's not my cup of tea, at least as of now. So I just make use of mascara as much as I can, and I'm happy, I'm satisfied with the amount of lashes that I am having. Next up, I have used the sugar highlighter in the shade Champagne. If you do not have a fan brush, then you can just use my advice. Is you can use a fluffy eyeshadow brush, apply your highlighter with this one, and just so that it does not look like a line and you have just used a highlighter on that accurate line, use a fluffy brush just as I have done here to smudge the highlighter, if that makes sense, so that it looks more diffused and you can just fake that you have that glow from within. Although most of the people know these days that we use highlighter. Yes, I have done it right here. I have used the backside of a fluffy brush to smudge the line just so that it does not look like you have used one single line of highlighter. Or maybe you have used a wrong brush. Makeup is all about jugaad. Next up, I have used the same Stay Quirky lipstick in the shade Rock My World, the one which we used in the blush. And now this just makes the look more cohesive when you have the similar tone of blush lipstick. If you are just confused of which lipstick to put, just make it somewhere similar to your lips and you'll end up having a very cohesive, beautiful look. This is what I did. Now this lipstick is not good if you have pigmented lips like me, it will show through, but this was the only pink lipstick that I had. And then I have just tried to do some posing just so that you could look at every side of my face and to see how the makeup will end. I thought in my confidence level. I do this posing just because I'm a newbie. So make sure give this video a thumbs up just so that I get a boost of confidence in a promotion. Anyways, but your feedbacks are always welcome for this video, for any video, for my posing session, my communication skill, if anything is there, if I want to improve, if I need to improve according to you, then your feedbacks are highly welcome in the comment section and on my Gmail as well, which is available in the description box. And yes, that's it. So this was it for the video, and I hope that you find this one helpful. And if you did, then you know the drill to like the video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you in my next one, and please don't forget to press that ring bell button just after you press the subscribe button, so that you will be notified every time I put a new video. And I'll see you in my next one. Until then, alright, and take care.